Right. Well, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, all. Today, I want to have a chat with you. Anyway, thanks for as well letting me do this session. Talking about supercharging Planner with SharePoint framework and app-powered tasks. So let's get into it. So this is me, Simon Doy, an MVP in the M365 and M365 dev space. Owner of, I run a user group. It's going to be 11 years old this year, actually, as well. And I've been doing this stuff for a while now, so I'm getting quite old. The agenda today, we've got to start off with why would you want to use app-powered tasks? So we'll talk about that. We'll explain what they are, and then we'll do a demo and then do an overview of the code. And hopefully I will get this all done within the time I've got. So first of all, why? So what if you could see all the things that you need to get done, all the tasks, all in one place? You know, got that central source of truth. And, you know, that wouldn't just be tasks which are just Microsoft 365. It could be tasks to do with external systems, maybe business processes and more. Just having that one place where all the things you need to get done is there in one place. And what about if you had control, like full control over how those tasks are action and process? Maybe there's a wizard that you'd go through. You know, we're devs, we like to have control. So imagine that. In my opinion, I think that Planner should be the place to manage your tasks in Microsoft 365, and actually just in general in your business, in your organization. You know, that's what we're looking to achieve. And of course, we need to be able to access this via SharePoint and through connections too, which we can do with those great ACE cards that Derek was talking about earlier. So we've got access whether we are a laptop or on a mobile phone through the Teams app, through that dashboard. The problem is that Planner does have some issues out of the box. For example, users can delete tasks, their own tasks. They can edit each other's tasks. They can delete tasks which don't belong to them. And we don't have that control of the user interface. Maybe you want to capture some more information. Well, you can't sort of customize that user interface. So that's where Planner app-powered tasks come in. They integrate directly into Planner, as you can see on the screenshot to the right of you. They integrate into Microsoft Teams as well, so they use Teams apps. And we've got full control of the user interface. The one thing that I do need to bring to your attention is that they are built on the Business Scenarios Graph API, and the API is currently in beta. Chatting with the Planner team, you know, they're really looking to get feedback on these APIs, on this solution, so that they can get it into GA. So here's just a quick overview of how it might look, and we'll go into a demo shortly. So it's all nicely integrated into Teams, so there's no messing about going from one app to another, which is really nice. But what do you need? What do you need to build these? Well, first of all, you need Planner. You do need to create a Microsoft ID application, an entry ID application, which is going to be the owner of the plan and the business scenario plan, going to be creating the tasks and managing those tasks. In this example, we have an SPFx Teams app, which, you know, why would you not use SharePoint framework to do this? And we then have an Azure function to process the activities from that Teams app. So as you can see, Planner gets calls at something called a Teams staging URL, which opens up your Teams app in a nice dialogue. And then that's going to show our SPFx application. And then that application is going to work with the tasks using the Azure function API. So let's go into a demo. Our demo is this. An often needed solution is read receipts. So organizations often need employees to confirm they've read a document or a policy. Maybe you're doing something with AI. Maybe there's that thing, that Copilot thing, which you need to make sure that people understand how to use it and using the right tools within your business, maybe not using ChatGPT or using Copilot instead. in all, you know, in this solution, we need to be able to audit and provide proof that the users have read this document, and we really don't want others to be able to edit someone else's task, or even worse, users be able to delete these tasks to go and read this document. So it's demo time. Let's show you what this looks like. And this is in homage to April and David's presentation last week. So what we've got, we've got Postman. We've got an Azure function, as we said, and we're using Postman just to kind of simulate the creation of a business scenario task. Some things I want to just highlight. This external ID, this is the ID which we're going to use to look up and find our business scenario tasks. And these IDs need to be unique for every task you've got. I've sort of got into the habit of using a prefixed bit of text around the business scenarios. Maybe it's the business process. I'm using a date, time, and then the person who we're going to assign it to. So I'm going to update that ID, and I'm going to click send. And what's going to happen, all being well, all the demo pods being with us, is it's going to create a task and then on within Planner. So fortunately, that's taken a bit of time. We've got a 204. So let's just flip to Teams and find the right team. There we go. And we should see we've got some activity. So we can see here that the organization has assigned a task, and here is our task. And it's not quite worked. It's always the way, isn't it, with demos? Let me just quickly go into Planner, so because it looks a bit better in here. So I'll go into this one. And I'm going to open up here. So I just wanted to show off because you get a nice Word icon and things in here. So I click on this. Now it's caught, the UI is caught up. So in here, we've now got very similar app, UI as we expect from Planner. But everything's read-only here. We've got an indicator that this is an app-powered task. We've got this little app icon. And I've got a button here to start the task. So I'll click on this, and it's going to pop up using that team staging link, our Teams app. And here, as you'd expect from a task application, we've got some information about the task, what the title is. We've got a description over what we need to do for the task and how many percent it's complete. And we've got a link to the guide, which I could click on, and that'll pop up a window. I can then confirm that I've read the content. I might need to provide the level of understanding that I fully understood the content. And, I can click on save, and that will process our task. If I was a bit of a better dev, I'd probably get that to close as well, but anyway, there we go. But what's that going to do? Well, that will then talk to our Azure function and tell it to complete the task and show that. And we should see this get crossed out. And if I look at the task in here, we will then see that it's refreshed and close that task. And no longer can we work with that task anymore. It's all been completed. We can see some notes in here which have been added to provide some audit of what happened. So we can see that the task has been completed and the level of understanding that was passed through as well. So that's a quick demo. And I can see I've got about 5 minutes left. So great. I'm going to switch back to my slide. So next we're going to do is just sort of go through an overview of the code. And then I will share some links and some resources for you to be able to try this stuff out. So let's start with the SharePoint framework solution first. I quickly, hurriedly hid all the API keys because I thought that might be bad if I show those. So we've got a SharePoint framework solution. This has been built, it's quite a while ago now, using the Teams toolkit. It's not doing anything too spectacular. It's creating our special service, which we're going to use to interact with that Azure function. There's a couple of things I really want to highlight. One of the challenges I had when building this was, how am I going to pass in which task someone is going to which task someone needs to see? And so You have the ability within the Teams URLs to be able to pass through a subpage ID, and we're using that to hold which task needs to be loaded. So when I go into the Visual Studio C# code, then I'll highlight that. But we grab the task ID, and then we can then use that to go and grab the data. This will load up our interface. So a habit we've got into, I think, is using Formic for our forms. This is loading up the task with all the ID and the title and the description and all that good stuff. We've got the link to the content. And as you saw in the demo, here's where we've got the toggle and the drop downs. Once we go through, the user clicks on this submit button, it's going to call a function within our service. And we've got a few service functions here, one to get that task, one to update the task, and then one to complete it as well. So this is what we saw when we clicked on the save, and it completed that task and called our Azure function. So all good stuff. If I flip over to the .NET code, which is the Azure function, this is where kind of more of the interactions with business scenarios, the APIs is going. So we've got this create, connect, sync, plan function, which basically is called, every plan needs to be hosted within a Microsoft 365 group. So we have this business scenario group target. We need to load in some configuration settings. We need to get the details around our Enter ID app, and then create this business scenario group target. We go through, we just check to make sure that the business scenario exists, and if it doesn't exist, we're going to create it. The thing is it's the app which owns this plan, and so you can see that we are passing in, we can pass a list of client IDs, so application IDs, which own that plan, so it doesn't have to be just one, and we're going to create that business scenario. Once we've done that, we're going to build up this sort of plan reference and start to configure our plan with the different buckets and things in there, which is what all this is doing. I really want to get to the creating the task, so I'll just push through here. Within business scenarios, we can sort of configure the plan and what things can happen on it. So we can say whether activities are allowed or blocked. So we can, for example, stop people deleting tasks, maybe block people from changing the percent complete or moving things around. So you can actually, with business scenarios, control the planner. There is some work that needs to be happening on the user experience. But it does work. It just gives some interesting error messages sometimes. But that will then go and create our plan. And if we move then to the last part of it here, which is creating a business scenario task. Again, we're loading up our Enter ID. We took in that JSON object when we saw from the demo and deserialized that. And that'll give us information around what the task ID and the links to the content, which we need to see. And I've got about 30 seconds. This is the hardest part, was creating these app links. And I just would call you to have a look at the blog guide and the code. We have to create this content object, which has a Teams app ID and a link to the component within your Teams tab, along with that link. And that's what we're going to create through. We create these external entities, and that's how Planner knows how to open up. And I'm going to just finally flip over to, I can see I'm running out of time, to the resources. So there's three resources here. There's a link to a blog series around app-powered tasks. There's a link to a Microsoft Learn article on managing and the app-powered tasks. And finally, there's a link to the GitHub repo. So have a look at that. I'm always here. Just give us a shout on Blue Sky, and I will hand back to Chris.